My Hollow.
And I'm Big Ange, and you're on Broken Neck Radio. Fucking metal that makes you want to break shit. Break shit now.
Hey, this is Reckless Ron here at the Wacken Metal Battle Canada. And I have with me now My Hollow, one of five bands that are competing in the finale. That one winner will rule them all and head off to Wacken, Germany for one of the biggest metal fests in the world. So with me, I have Angelo and Graham.
Yes, how are you?
Graham, fine, thank you.
I am also well.
Ah, good. Are you guys stoked to be here today? I mean, what's the deal?
Oh, dude, I'm like on cloud nine, man. I've been floating all day. Got like the jitters.
I can see it in your eyes.
Yeah, no, there's no better feeling than what's going on with us right now. It's just the best, pretty much the biggest and best show we think we're ever going to play here.
Now, so, you know, I'm really glad to have this chance to chat with you guys before the show. And you guys have been breaking your drums since 2008.
That's right.
And so can you give the Broken Neck listeners a brief history of how My Hollow came to be and what all inspired of each of you to arrive where you are at today?
Sure. I mean, I came from BC and came up to Toronto to play music. That was my whole goal. That was everything I wanted to do. And I came and figured BC wasn't really happening for me. So I was like, I'm going to move to the big city and start rocking out. And just some time went by, and I ran into these guys via you know, like other people and internet, and just meeting other people, and came out and tried out for them. And that's how I got into the band.
That's right.
Thanks, Graham. So it's been a natural progression, and the response has been overall positive. Let's talk about songwriting and you know, the integrity that your music puts out there. I mean, do you guys? How does the writing process go?
Our writing process for the first bit was pretty much all like hands-on. Like everything was done in studio. We wrote songs in the studio, everything like that. It was just the group of us all together writing. Mm-hmm. Over the years, we've actually progressed and gotten more into a lot more programming at home. Everybody working on their own individual stuff, and then sending stuff out. I mean, we use a program called Dropbox. It's been really good, and having riffs and writing at home, and then bringing it to the jam space, and then really working on it there. And it's just that the time and the quality of music has gone up a lot since we started doing that the last couple of years.
Yeah, there's nothing worse than showing up with your guitar and being like, oh man, I made this awesome riff at home, and shit, no, that's not how it goes. Damn it, that's like that. Uh-huh. Nah, shit, it's not like this. Okay, I'll come back next week.
Yeah, everybody's
spending a half hour just trying to remember the damn thing. So
yeah, everybody's got their own recording program, so we all work at from home. Bring everything to the table at the space and work on it.
That's true. Like all this technology that's now available to musicians has really empowered a lot. You
have to take advantage right now. You have to take advantage of all the social media, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. It doesn't matter if you love it or hate it. You got to take advantage of it. And we are definitely, we're not trying to clog it though. We don't want to piss people off or annoy anyone. You know, the odd post here or there, you know, really for important shit. We don't want to put whatever we eat every day on, you know, posted on Facebook. You know, we want to show people what we kill, not eat.
So you guys, like I said, are a Toronto band, so this is your stomping ground, really. And let's talk about the last show that you had at the Cathedral in late 2000. And then that's where you had, and where were your heads at, and how was the recording of Live Off the Floor? Can you give us some more about that?
Playing the Cathedral, playing the last, with a second to last band ever to play the Cathedral here in Toronto, which is like a landmark for metal bands, punk bands, grunge, anything. I mean, everything it played at the Cathedral, and it was I think our third time playing at the Cathedral. Third time, and just to be there the last night, the closing night, was just chaotic. Mm-hmm. The place was nuts. Like it was just, there was people breaking shit all over the place. The place got torn to pieces.
Oh, really?
It was just a riot, man. It was just a great experience.
It was a beautiful thing. And then we went into the studio there for the Live Off the Floor, and I mean, it was better than nothing. It's a pretty good start for anybody, but we kind of brushed that under the rug, and then we got our decent EP out. Now we're working on a full-length album, and we're hoping it should be out soon as well.
That sounds good.
Yes, sir.
You've been touring with other bands such as Beneath, Warbringer, Kill Devil Hill. The Agonist, Cryptopracy, Vital Remains, and Destruction to name a few. Does the fan in you come out to play, or you just can't believe that you're sharing the stage in the same league as your peers, and you feel you must outdo them?
We played with some pretty incredible bands. We've had the opportunity to play with some amazing bands, and it's not for us. It's always about going up and destroying. It doesn't matter who we're playing with. I mean, and it's not about crushing other bands. That's not it. It's just about going, being motivated by how great these bands are, and just getting so pumped that we just want like everything to just be destroyed. You know, like we want them to almost see us as an opening act for them to go, okay, we're gonna step it up a notch. We're gonna step it up a notch because we're getting a little comfortable. We've been, you know, we're gonna bring out some of our tricks and really slay. So we've had good response with every band we've played with, and it's just been an honor to play with so many great bands.
Very cool. I thoroughly enjoyed your EP, Cold Dark Days.
Thank you, Reckless.
Seems Seep Red, Kings with No Castles, and Blood Seeds, all great songs. We've been supporting you here on Broken Neck Radio, and we look forward to doing that down the road. So what can we let everyone know that you guys got planned down the road? And what future dates could you share with us, festivals or different club tours?
Well, we have been working on a full length for quite some time now, and we kind of put a bit of a hold on it due to this competition and stuff. We just really turned our focus on this. We're getting right back on board on this album because it's nearly finished. We don't have a release date or anything yet. But we're really drilling it, and it's going to be a fantastic album. It's the best work that we've ever done, and we'll be showcasing some of that even tonight. You know, some stuff that no one's heard us play. So it's been a lot of fun.
Having said that as well, we are playing a Leamington Squirrel Festival at the end of June. We're going to be staying overnight there, camping, partying, ripping it up.
Dude, that's my neck of the woods. I'm from that way.
No way.
Yeah.
So is Greg Gallagher, lead guitarist from My Hollow. That's his neck of the woods as well. We're going to be partying it up with a lot of his old friends. And the following day, we're playing at the Dominion House in Windsor with Threat Signal and a bunch of other bands there. So it's just going to be an epic, awesome time. Depending on what happens here tonight, we have a show booked with The Agonist and potentially Burning the Day as well at the Rock Pile. So, but whoever wins tonight, if it's either us or Burning the Day, we're not going to be there. So one of us is dropping off the bill after tonight, maybe. There's a 2 in 5 chance right now that's gonna happen. Yeah. So fingers crossed, obviously.
That sounds good, man.
Yeah, man.
All right, so overall your experience with the Whack and Metal Battle Canada has been pretty good. And so what tips of encouragement could you pass on to next year's entrants?
I'd say tips, like when you going into it, you really got to look at it as a show. You know, you can't go into it really looking at it as a competition. Like it's great to get to meet all these bands, and all the bands have just been super awesome. We're all chilling back here, all getting along, having a great time. And I think if you go in it with that attitude, you're just gonna have a real good feeling on stage, and you're just gonna kill it, right? You know, knowing the people that you're competing against, but being friendly and having a good time.
Yeah, I get you. So if you guys win this battle and head overseas to Germany to whip up the pits, what is the biggest expectation you have for Wacken, and have you preparations in place?
I'll let you take that one.
Sorry, what was the question?
What do you expect from Wacken?
Was that cute?
You know?
Sorry, there was a hot chick walking by there. You know what happens, Reckless Rod. You know how it is. No, what could you not expect from there? It's
you're going to be playing 30,000. What's the number?
I don't even know. And you know what? Whether or not we play in front of 5 people or 500,000, we're going to rip it up the exact same way.
Right.
Obviously, it's going to be the biggest epic event that any local band can go ask for and get shipped over to some country in Europe just to go rip it up over there with the best of the best. So, you have to expect the unexpected, and we're pretty much ready for whatever. We'll sleep on the streets if we have to, and get up in the morning and get ready to rip at 10 a.m. if we have to.
Excellent. That sounds... pretty much the way it is, you know. You make music that you enjoy, and you enjoy just fucking ripping it out, and everyone else gets it, you know. I fully get it, and I am so honored to have this opportunity to chat with you guys here at Whack and Metal Ball Canada, finale at the Opera House, thank you. And looking forward to playing your music for many years to come on Broken Neck Radio. I've got Sunday Thrash Blast and Wednesday Midweek Meltdown, so, you know.
Wicked.